Hello, my name is Aamyie Ecker and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing look number two using the Juvia's Place Nubian 3 Coral Palette. Absolutely love this palette. Thank you, Sabrina, the Makeup Mom, Sabrina Ecker. I'll get her new name down. Anyways, she recommended this on her channel. I'd been looking at it, but really have been in a no-buy. I just haven't felt like if it doesn't come in a beauty box, I don't know. There's just not been anything out there that has wowed me. So I kind of had my eye on this one. I was like, along with their foundation. So I did a foundation review and that will be coming out either before or after. Who knows? But anyways, back to this palette. Thank you, Sabrina, because I had been on the fence about this. Wasn't sure. I love peaches or corals. And so, yeah, I was curious because those are kind of my favorites to play with. Today I will talk only on the ones that I used. So I've used these colors here and that one there, and I like it. I really like the palette. So what I find that I enjoy is these shimmer colors because I can actually use a brush with them. Don't ask me why. I'm a little weird. I'm a lot weird, but I do like using shimmers with a brush, and these you can use a brush with. So it picks up a nice shimmer color, goes on. You don't have to pack it on. You just kind of swipe and go. Sabrina and I were talking about this palette last night because she was asking me how I felt about the grays. So I gave her my thoughts on that, and you can see that in another video. But we were talking, she said hers kind of had a film a little bit on top. I believe that I had seen a video a long time ago when people put out the shimmers or the really pretty highlights that sometimes for packaging they do put a very light film on top. So if you find your first swipes aren't what you'd like them, don't give up. Just get that top layer of film for shipping off. And I'm assuming that's what it is, because like I said, I've had no issues. And she said once she got past that top layer, hers went really good. So I love the fact, again, that I can use a brush to put on these shimmers. Really, really love that. These colors here are absolutely blendable. Again, I mean, I can tilt my head back and there's no patchiness. The colors blend really, really nice. As far as their performance goes, I was shocked. These seem to be close enough that you probably don't need to use both, but if you do like I did, these are close enough that the colors just go blend really well together and you don't have to do over blending, so to speak, to get rid of any harsh lines because those are close enough. So I thought that was kind of brilliant. This palette, and then I came down to this darker, so I start at the lightest and then move my way down. Even though this is a different color than these, once again, when you start playing with the colors, they just blend well. I like the fact that this could be even for a palette for someone that is very new to makeup, wants to try it, really, you know, wants to learn how to use makeup. This one is going to be a great starter palette for you, and for those of you that really enjoy makeup, are comfortable with colors, etc., this is still going to be a good palette for you. I think the quality of the shadows are really good. Again, they blend really nice and effortlessly, which I love. I hate when I have to continue to work on blending. I like palettes or makeup like this that just goes and it just flows and it doesn't get muddy, but it still holds its color and it just blends beautifully. So I have to say, as far as the coral piece to this palette, absolutely fantastic. I do want to create at least one more look using maybe some more shimmers. I'm not sure if I'll do that on camera or not, but yeah, I'm curious about using all of these because I've had a really good, I don't want to say really good luck because that makes it sound like I won the lottery, but I will say Juvia's Place, as far as your quality goes, spot on. Absolutely amazing. Great palette. I can't say enough great things about it just with the colors that I've used so far. So hope you guys enjoy this video. If you want to see how I created this look, you're in the right spot, so stay tuned. And if you have any comments, questions, thoughts, etc., please put those below. All right, y'all, let's get started.
Use this grayish color here.
For our base.
We're gonna pick up this color here.
Yeah.
I'm gonna deepen that coral up with this one here, just slightly underneath that last coral, more in the crease. I'm gonna grab this one right here for the lid. I think today we're gonna use this peach here. I'm gonna grab one of my flat brushes. Picking back up the brush that I just used, I'm gonna go ahead and pick back up this color here. And make sure I don't have any strong lines. Just kind of buffing it out. Next, I'm gonna pick up this color here. Again, I'm gonna go back to my last brush and just kind of buff that out. Okay, I'm gonna use my Inglot eyeliner. Okay, I've got makeup everywhere. Here, here. Not makeup, mascara. All right, we're gonna put on some mischievous eyelashes for Makeup Geek. Okay, while those are setting up, I'm gonna go ahead and work on the lower lash line. I'm actually gonna use Makeup Geek's dark brown eyebrow pencil. Because I like the chocolatey look. Then on a pencil brush, I'm gonna pick up this nice color here. Go right over the top. And on the inner waterline, I'm gonna use Orchid from Makeup Geek. Okay, so this kind of completes the coral look. What do y'all think? Thank you so much for watching this video on the Juvia's Place Nubian 3 Coral Palette. It is a great palette to put in your arsenal of beauty products, especially if you love corals or peaches like I do. It's just a great palette. So, again, hope you enjoyed the video, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one.
TTFN. Ta-ta for now. Ta-ta for now.